Bonjour, je m'appelle Kristian et bienvenue sur mes boutons de chemise à l'eau. If you don't know me, my name is Kristian. I am 22 years old. I moved to California about 2 years ago, and my life is... Child, my life is life in every damn day. As you can tell by this video, I am giving you a story time about my travel to France. I guess you guys don't know because this will be the first video that will be going up. I am currently in Paris, France right now. I am here for about a week and a couple of days or something like that. I got here on Wednesday, January 11th. And today is Saturday, January 14th. And I just kind of wanted to give you guys like a story time of what arriving to Paris was really like for me, because I was practically bedridden for 2 fucking days. So if you guys want to hear about this little story time, go ahead and stick around. Let's just get it on and pop it, right? So I flew here, came to Paris, and I flew Delta. I'm flying Delta all the way. I fly from San Diego, have a layover in Salt Lake City, which, mind you, my flight, well, like, let's just start off with one. My layover in Salt Lake City was 30 minutes. Do you know how long it takes to deboard a plane?
I'm here to tell you right now, we don't care.
Let me tell you.
We don't care.
And for, like, and I'm wearing, mind you, I'm wearing my Birkin clogs. My Birkin clogs. So, like, when I get off the plane finally, I am sprinting as fast as I can. And these clogs, also, they're, like, damn near brand new, so they're hurting my fucking feet as I'm running, right? But I'm still running throughout the concourse to get to the next fucking terminal. Make it though. Made it though. So bitch, don't ever try me. I'll still run up and whoop your ass in some clogs, ho. Never try it. That's flat one. I have a 30 fucking minute layover. Get on the second flight. The second flight is from Salt Lake City to Paris. When you have a longer flight like that, you always get an entree. So they come around with the food pretty early into the flight, mind you. I think it's like an hour and a half into the flight. I get like a chicken entree, and the side is a chickpea salad. I'm allergic to all nut products, and my allergy is pretty severe. It's like 5 to 10% of people with a nut allergy are also allergic to like chickpeas and stuff like that. So I let them know that, hey, I can't have this. I'm allergic to all nuts, and that includes chickpeas for me, unfortunately. So they're like, okay, well, we don't have any other side options. And I'm like, Anaheim, what the fuck do you mean you don't have any other side options? It is 2023. You don't have a non-nut, you don't have a nut-free side, or you just don't have multiple side options on a fucking 10-hour flight. And so I'm like, okay, well, I guess I'm a fucking starve, because I didn't eat at all, because I don't really eat on travel days. So they come back around and I'm like, hey, you got another entree? Because like, I'm hungry. So they're like, oh yeah, we have the ravioli one. Cool. Mind you, I'm still talking to the same flight attendant. And I get it. There's a lot of people on this flight. There's a lot of things to keep up with. But like, someone telling you that they have a food allergy is very fucking important for you to remember. Let's just keep that in mind. So she's like, oh, look, we have the ravioli entree, which was the other entree. She was like, we can give you that. And I was like, cool, bet. I will gladly take that. So they bring me the ravioli entree. I'm eating it. I'm realizing there's something green on it. I look on the lid. It says ravioli with pesto. Now, I'm gonna just put it here. What the fuck pesto is made with, bitch. Ugh. But then on the label, you know where it'd be like, contains blah, 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 blah. All it says is milk, eggs, and wheat. It don't say nuts nowhere on there. So I've always wanted to try pesto because people be wanting to shove that shit up their pussy. That's how good they be making it sound. So I've always wanted to fucking try pesto. So I was like, oh my god. And I don't really fly Delta because who the fuck needs to do all that within the States? So I'm like, oh my god. I get what people are fucking talking about with Delta. Like, Delta is that, wow. Like, they got enough money that they can make nut-free pesto. You bitches can never. Trader Joe's, Whole Foods, Air One, Aldi, Sprouts. You hoes could never make a pesto with nuts not added. My bitch Delta though? Yeah. You know why? Because that's called luxury. You hoes don't even know what luxury is. You don't even know how to spell it. If I pulled you a Keela and a Bee style and said spell luxury ho, you would just sit there and fucking fumble and lose.
I-D-O-C-I. IBIS, iridocyclitis.
You would not be moving on to the next round. And I don't know what to tell you. Like, that's what I had thought, right? That this is just me, prior to me thinking. So I'm eating, I'm like, oh, okay, cool. It don't say it got nuts. Cause you would think that's something that they would put on there, right? You think so, right? The tummy started grumbling. And I said, ew, ew. I'm sitting there on the flight, I'm like, wow. I gotta poop. Gotta fart and I gotta poop. The tummy was a grumbling and grooving. I was like, maybe, just maybe. And I also had a can of sparkling wine. I said, well, maybe there's just a lot of moving and grooving in there with this plane. Maybe I need to take me a little ass nap. Okay, maybe I just need to take my ass a nap. As we are about to make our final descent into Paris, which is only, there's only one descent into Paris. But our final descent into Paris, the stomach had enough. She was sick. She was done playing with me. Like, she was like, you're not listening. And I'm telling you that I'm about to motherfucking blow. I don't know what to tell you. So I'm like, oh girl, this is it. And it's like, when I say final descent, it's like, put on your seatbelts. You're not allowed to move. That's the final descent, right? Mino, no. Tell me that it's time to go, so I gotta go.
Oh, nah, we gotta go?
So I get up, run to the bathroom, and there she blows. And there was the motherfucking toilet hoe. I wish I would've took a picture or something. I don't know why I would've, but I wish I would've because baby, it gave chunks of plenty. It was giving disgusting.
Disgusting.
No, literally just blue chunks in that fucking bathroom, right? At least now I threw up, I feel better, period. So I land, get my bags, or do customs, get my Navigo de Cubillas card, which is just like an unlimited travel card. Sorry, you wouldn't know that. You're not Parisian like me. You're not French. Sissy. Get all that. That's fine. And then I have an Airbnb, which is where I'm at currently. But I couldn't check in for 6 hours because I landed around like 8 a.m. and I couldn't check in. But like once I get all my, like all that shit, it's like closer to 10. But I couldn't check in until 4 p.m. So I was like, okay, I'm just gonna go near the Eiffel Tower, figure something to do. There's always something to do over there, right? On the train, I'm like 2 stops away, right? 2. You can count them. So I have to transition trains before I get to the 2 stops away. So as I'm transitioning trains, the stomach is like,
surprise, bitch. I bet you thought you'd seen the last of me.
That's what the stomach was saying to me. Like, she was really like, and it wasn't like, hey, bitch. No, it was like a whisper. Like, only I could hear it. And I was like, girl, please. What I gotta do? I'll fucking swallow for you to not come back. Like, I don't know. Like, please. Let me be, stomach. Like, I'm in Paris. I can't do it, stomach. I can't do it. That's what I was saying back to her. And so I proceed to transition on the train. I'm like, okay. And then she gets to grumbling and googling and the stomach said, bitch, thar she blows again. Part 2, the remix. Therefore, she comes up, but I'm a bad bitch.
Yeah, I'm a bad bitch. You can't kill me.
You not finna take me out the game like that, ho. She comes up, and I say, because one thing about me, I'll never let it slip out this mouth, ho. So I said, because it was like a little baby bump. I said, period. That's the first time I ever swallowed. We'll never do that again, ho. So all you men out there, I'm so sorry. It'll never be fucking me. And then a big one comes up. I'm like, but in my head I said, I did this before. You a bad bitch. You a down for it all, bitch. I believe in you, Kristian. I believe in you. And so I proceed to try to swallow it, right? The stomach said, stop. Stop.
Like, it's not the vibe. Stop!
I got something for your ass. Because technically that was round 2, because the first one I swallowed. She said, here's round 3. Top that. As I'm trying to swallow round 2. Well, at that point, I just had to give in. I want y'all to remember, all this is happening and I'm on the motherfucking train. So then it all just comes out the mouth. On the train, yeah. Yeah, in fact it does. Mind you, I'm sitting right here on the train. There's a girl right here, there's someone across from me, and there's people in front of me looking at me because we had just come to a stop. And it all just comes out. It goes all over my suitcase, all over the floor. I have never been more fucking mortified in my life. All aboard the choo-choo train, all aboard the choo-choo train, all aboard the choo-choo train, all aboard, choo-choo. I want to cry. So I run the fuck off the train, and as I'm trying to run off the train, as I said, this is all happening at a stop. The stops don't last that long, so by the time I'm trying to get off the train is trying to go. So the door is shutting and hits me, but thankfully I'm a bad bitch and I took that shit like a motherfucking G, and I still got off the motherfucking train. Ran to the closest trash can to finish throwing up, and it wasn't like I wasn't prepared to like spit it out. So there's this throw up all over my face, and I'm trying to wipe it off. At this point, I'm crying because it hurt how bad I was throwing up. And then I call my mom. She's trying not to freak out, but she's like low-key freaking out, like, Kristian, you've never done this. Because usually when I have a reaction to nuts, I only throw up the one time, and I'm motherfucking G, I'm good to go. I don't know what I was trying to throw up there. Big C, big C, big B, big B. I don't, girl. Let me not get shot up. Yeah, so call my mom. I'm sitting on a chair just like figuring out what the fuck to do next, because now I'm like, fuck, like I'm like, okay, well, I done thrown up twice, so I should for real be good now. So let me just go ahead and start walking to the Eiffel Tower and get back on the train, because another one will come in like 6 minutes. Also, mind you, my suitcase, I mean, it's not inside my suitcase, but my suitcase is like covered in throw up. I'm literally exhausted. Like, when I tell you, I'm sitting on this bench in the train station. If I was not on the phone with my mom, I would have went to sleep. I had no more energy left in me. So I'm like, I just need to lay down. I'm like, I need to book a hotel because I need to rest. I'm starting to call hotels. Mind you, part 40 motherfucking 5 of this story. To call anyone in Europe, at least with T-Mobile, that shit cost you. But I didn't give no fucks. Like, I'ma deal with that shit when I get home. So I'm sitting here calling 80 motherfucking hotels, like back to back to back to back to back.
Hi, I know this is totally last minute, but I was hoping that you could maybe get a flight from my boss from Miami to New York tonight. Yeah, any kind of jet. From Miami to New York.
Thank you.
Yes, I need it tonight.
No, it's over here, honey.
Hi, I'm trying to get a flight tonight from Miami to New York. Yes, I know there's a hurricane. Nothing is flying out. What do you mean nothing is flying out? It's from Miranda Priestley, and I know that she's a client of yours. She's flown with you before. Yes, hi, I need a jet tonight from Miami to New York. Yeah, sorry, hold on.
And literally the conversation is lasting less than a minute, like back to back to back to back. Like, hey, what's the earliest you can check in? Because at least, I don't know if it's a European thing, but it's for sure a Parisian thing. You ain't checking in until 2 to 4 p.m., baby. I don't know what the fuck to tell you, ho. That's just what they were saying. I dead ass called probably 30, 40 hotels in the span of literally 15 minutes. And they all said the same thing, except one. Hallelujah. Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever. From generation to generation, what they say be hallelujah, hallelujah, we worship you, Young Money, for who you are. All that to say, found a hotel, yeah. It was 40 minutes outside the city, 40 minutes the opposite way from my fucking Airbnb, right? But it's literally the only one that would let me check in immediately. I say, fuck it. I have to book it. My mom's like, book it, bitch. Like, I don't know what the fuck to tell you. Book it. And it was like a 40-minute train ride, right? And my mom was like, no. Just call an Uber. It was just a whole lot to be like dealing with the train. As I said, I'm literally falling asleep. So she was like, call an Uber. call an Uber, but as I'm booking the hotel and calling the Uber, I'm still in the train station, I throw up for a third time. Thankfully, I find a trash can. I throw up in a trash can. I don't even think I told my mom that I threw up the third time. But yeah, throw up the fucking third time. That one hurt, bitch. Cause like at that point there was really nothing to throw up. I think I was just still having a reaction. So it just hurt you. Like I know I've been playing up this story, but this reaction to like about that third time, that is all too real. Moving along, that one hurt. As I'm in the Uber, I'm asleep, nigga. Like I'm
my bad.
Get to the hotel. I think they could tell that I was out of commission because the receptionist just kept saying to me over and over, please have a drink, have something, like blah, 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 blah. Check into my hotel room, right? So you know what I did when I got there? Can you guess what I did when I got there, bitch? I threw up for the fourth motherfucking time. But after that, you know what I mean? After that time, I got into the bed. I got to the hotel around like 11:30-ish, went to sleep, got in that bed, and went straight the fuck to sleep. By the time I woke up, it's midnight. That is an entire day in Paris just gone. Just gone. I specifically landed at 8 a.m. so that I would have the full day to do something. But no. But alas, I spent it fucking throwing up. Thank you, Delta, you stupid fucking cunt. That's the whole fucking day in Paris gone. Also, I would have been fine with the jet lag had I not been asleep all day the first day. That jet lag is still fucking me up, and today is day 4. I'm hoping that because today is a chill day and I'm staying in the Airbnb all day, that I will be able to be good and not fucking worry about this jet lag anymore, because me sleeping all day fucked me up. All that to say, stayed up, couldn't go back to sleep until 11:30 a.m. the next day. But anyway, got out of bed around like 9:30 a.m. Thursday, packed all my shit, got an Uber, got to my Airbnb. I'm chilling, I'm like, oh, this is nice, boo boo boo. I'll show you guys the Airbnb at the end of this video. Cool, I'm gonna just chill for like 2 hours, charge up my phone, my Apple Watch and shit like that, my portable charger, so that I can go hit the motherfucking town because I've already missed a motherfucking day. I get here around 11:30 to 12. I wake up at 5:30. Did you? You heard what I said, right? I said I woke up at 5:30. Bitch, I wasn't even supposed to go the fuck to sleep. Oh, when I woke up, I was hot. Oh, okay, well, at this point, because there was no way I was going to get up at 5:30, try to scramble, figure out something to wear, wash my face, take a shower, brush my teeth and all that shit. No, I'm not finna stress myself the fuck out. So that's just another day in Paris motherfucking wasted. All due to motherfucking Delta. Like honestly, and I've already filed a complaint, but they said that a complaint could take up to 30 days to get back to me. Nah, I should motherfucking sue they ass. Because like, thankfully my reaction to not eating or consuming any nut product is I just throw up. But bitch, what if I needed an EpiPen, or what, and I didn't have it, or what if my throat closed and I wouldn't be able to breathe? Nigga, I could have died had my reaction been so severe. I could have fucking died because y'all don't know how to motherfucking label your fucking food or listen to your fucking customers when they tell you that they're allergic to something and yet you still suggest something that has that thing that they just told you that they're allergic to. It's alright. So Thursday just sat in here all day because I was like, well, fuck it. I'm not about to go do anything now, as I said. And then yesterday came, went out and did stuff. You guys will see more of starting yesterday in the vlog where I actually do stuff in Paris. So if you guys want to see that, go ahead and look forward to that. But that is going to conclude this motherfucking story time because I'm hot. Like, physically, right now, I could just take this cardigan off, but it's just, I'm looking at you, bitch. Fuck you. I don't want to take it off. That was really what I motherfucking went through to have to get here to motherfucking Perry. And oh, I don't know if I mentioned, I'm completely by myself here. There's no one else here. There's, like, I'm navigating. Granted, I mean, as I said, I'm talking to my mom. But, like, let's keep it a buck. I'm the only one here with me. Like, I'm navigating all of this by myself in person. In a foreign country where I don't speak the language. It'd be different if I was in fucking London. Where I could be like, yo, yo, pip, pip, cheerio, can you motherfucking help me? I'm just throwing up. I just need an Alka-Seltzer. An Alka-Seltzer. Can you get me a fucking Alka-Seltzer? Can you get me a motherfucking Tums? Can you get me a motherfucking Pepto-Bismol? I can't do that here because they're gonna look at me and be like, we don't speak of the Ebonics. Stop talking to me. Voulez-vous que j'ai avec toi? C'est soi. Or whatever the fuck, who said it? Which one of them little white girls said it? Was it Pink or was it Christina? But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you guys enjoyed this story time. I hope you're hashtag praying for me because baby, I'm gonna need it. Yeah. So that was my story time about my journey to Paris. But as of right now, everything else is going great besides like the weather, but honestly, as I said, I don't really mind it. I love you guys the most. If you guys enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Don't forget to share this video with your friends and your family because I post and I want them to see what I post. Also, don't forget to hit that post notification bell because I literally just said I post. I love you guys the most and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace out, Girl Scouts. East and the west, I'm racking up on my breath, power on me, I'm feeling just like a Tesla, too much tree, the smoke is making my chest hurt, girl on me, I'm thinking I should arrest her, hey, I'm thinking I should arrest, all night long, she putting me to the test.